Hi, this can only be Rides with Chuck. In this video, we take a look at a 1957 Dual-Ghia, and we go for a ride.
I know if you Google Dual-Ghia, as I did before I did this one, you show up with a really nice looking hat.
Good, good.
Matching
that,
outfit.
That would be my Pebble Beach outfit. Yeah, that's the only show that I dressed to match the car, and I really lucked out and found the perfect outfit and hat for this car.
Well, Chuck, this is a 1957 Dual-Ghia. They actually built Dual-Ghias from the end of 1956 till the beginning of 1958. And according to which source you talk to, some Dual-Ghias experts say there were 99 built, and the amount goes as high as 117. And the reason being that they didn't have exact records of a lot of prototypes they build and things like that. This Dual-Ghia we bought from the grandchildren of the original purchaser. The family name was Stewart. It was bought by an M. Stewart. We know it wasn't James Stewart's wife, and we know it wasn't Martha Stewart, because she's too young for that. But the family was from Portland, Oregon, and the car ended up in Chicago with the grandchildren. And we purchased it. It had been repainted silver, and we brought it back to what we are pretty sure was the original color, which is Calypso Coral. And the car has won at Pebble Beach, Amelia Island, Meadowbrook, pretty much every major show, and is known in the world of Dual-Ghias as the holy grail of Dual-Ghias. It's probably the most authentic and best restored one there is. There are approximately 25 or so that exist, and this has all, the only thing missing when we bought it from the original family was the ashtray, and Dr. Paul Sable, who is the Dual-Ghia guru, actually found a ashtray for us. So we're always thankful to him for that.
What do you think of this car?
I love it. I tend to like the 30s cars better, but this for a 50s car is my absolute favorite. I really do. I love it. I love the color. I love the way it drives. It's just a wonderful car.
This is a unibody automobile. It isn't a deal where you take the body off the frame and then you can restore everything. You better find, if you're going to restore a car like this, you better find one that hasn't had any rust, because if you get rust along the lower panels and that, you've got a real problem to restore the car, and probably won't be as good as you'd like it to be. This car was a rust-free car. Was indoors its whole life, never sat outside, and we were very fortunate. It had, the only damage that we could detect the car ever had was minor damage to the right front fender years ago. That probably is when they had repainted the car. So, like I say, we were fortunate to find such a good example to start with. This is an early one. It's number 30 out of, like I say, approximately 100 built, and it has crank windows, which were built on all of them up until kind of the part of the series of Dual-Ghia convertibles. And the owners were all contacted when they came out with power windows that they could bring their cars back and have them retrofitted. Well, these people chose not to, so these are the original crank windows. Actually, I'm kind of happy that it does have. If you look closely at things like the hubcaps, those are the actual hubcaps. This car had all the original pieces on the car, but the hubcaps are very unusual, and they have probably, I don't know, 30 or 40 pieces in the hubcaps. And when people restore Dual-Ghias, they usually can't find the hubcaps, so they put wire wheels on. And a lot of people say that that was an option. Well, it actually was not an option. And if you look on the dash panel, you'll see the on the glove compartment door, the plates that they put on for the original owners of the car. And in the center below the radio are the heater controls. Now, later on, they moved the heater controls to a different part of the dashboard, and they put the power window buttons where the heater controls are. So the power window buttons were never on the doors when they did have power windows. Now, this is one of approximately 25% of the Dual-Ghias that was equipped with a Hemi engine, which means hemispherical heads. The front portion has a cover that goes over it. I have the cover off so we can keep the battery charged. But you see what's down in here, the horns and the reason that they have this cover is with all this space for the air to cool off the engine to get to the radiator, you've probably got about from the front of the car maybe close to 3 feet from the front bumper. And what that does is funnel the air in so it doesn't dissipate before it gets to the point where it's cooling down the engine. The hemispherical engine is a 315 cubic inch with a four barrel carburetor, and it has a Chrysler power flight transmission, and the transmission is really only a two-speed, so it isn't a jackrabbit start type situation, but once the car is rolling, it's pretty fast. Right now, Jim Cowan, who is the CEO of Automodello, is measuring the car for an upcoming model that they're making in 1/24th scale. Automodello is one of the best model makers with probably the best detail and high quality that you can purchase. And they're doing this car mid-spring 2013.